was once a velveteen rabbit, and in the beginning he was really splendid. He was fat and bunchy, as a rabbit should be. His coat was spotted brown and white. He had real thread whiskers, and his ears were lined with pink sateen. On Christmas morning, when he sat stocking with a sprig of holly between his paws, the effect was charming. There were other things in the stocking, nuts and oranges and a toy engine and chocolate and a clockwork mouse, but the rabbit was quite the best of all. For at least 2 hours, the boy loved him, and then aunts and uncles came to dinner, and there was a great rustling of tissue paper and unwrapping of parcels, and in the excitement of looking at all the new presents, the velveteen rabbit was forgotten. Seasons. Velveteen splendid games together, in whispers, when Nana had gone away to her supper and left the nightlight burning on the mantelpiece. And when the boy dropped off to sleep, the rabbit would snuggle down close under his little warm chin and dream, with the boy's hands clasped close round. Built for him under the To him. shabbiness doesn't matter. And then, one day, the boy was ill. His face grew very flushed, and he talked in his sleep, and his little body was so hot that it burned the rabbit when he held him close. Strange people came and went in the nursery, and a light burned all night, and through it all, the little velveteen rabbit lay there, hidden from sight, under the bedclothes, and he never stirred.
Going to the seaside, and that in itself was
as the others did, and he grew so excited that when at last he did stop to look for the berry, she had gone. He was a real rabbit at last, at home with the other rabbits. Let me have another little bit of tea. Autumn passed, and winter, and in the spring, when the days grew warm and sunny, the boy went out to play in the wood behind the house, and while he was playing, two rabbits crept out from the bracken and peeped at him. One of them was brown all over, but the other had strange markings under his fur, as though long ago he had been spotted, and the spots still showed through. And about his little soft nose and his round black eyes, there was something familiar, so that the boy thought to himself, "Why, he looks just like my old bunny that was lost when I had scarlet fever." Here is the bunny turning into a real rabbit, and here are the other rabbits running about in the wood. But he never knew that it really was his own.
This is being